Thank you for giving me the possibility to say more about this area. And I will drop some lines to the idea of simplification of payment process itself and payment behavior for customer. First of all, first of all, some words about why it is such important idea for me and for my country. Russia itself is quite a difficult country to operate in, and there are many different ideas why it is so. But all the environment of Russia is very big. Russia is a huge country, and it is very uneven. One point of Russia is Moscow, its capital, and it looks absolutely like New York. Nobody sleeps, all people are all the time running. There is maybe the worst traffic jams all over the world, and every person has two smartphones and three credit cards. And there are Far East regions which look absolutely different, and nobody knows about distant banking or credits or maybe even internet access. And banking experience is also very different from point to point. And here is one bank, but absolutely different user experiences. Here is modern and innovative application of Sberbank, which I use day by day, and their village branch. And it is not old one, but absolutely modern. Sberbank has even one branch on the board to reach unreachable regions, and one branch all on their special crossroad transport. And in this landscape, there are very difficult to pull customer from the cash, from the most universal instrument of payment, to the digital payment. Why? We have now statistic which is growing and showing us that customers start to use cards from year to year more active. Even now, more than 85% of cards volume in Russia is withdrawal. Twice a month, people go to the ATM at the salary day and withdraw almost all the volume which they've got to the customer to the card balance. And why do they do it? Because less half of the retail outlets accept cards. There is lack of card acceptance all over the Russia. But in Moscow, in St. Petersburg, every small retail outlet is accepting Visa, MasterCard, China Union Pay, even JCB. And this story about card withdrawal experience and then, how to call it, digitizing cash back when customers bring their cash to pay utility bills, also one or two times a month, is growing up in Russia, and is the trend is not very positive. What do we have in this landscape? We have kind of zoopark of different payment instruments, different payment options, and it doesn't look as smooth as it is on the picture, because if you see at payment kiosks, if you know, I'm afraid in Europe you don't have such instrument. It is kind of cash-in ATM, which is used only for getting cash from customer and bringing it to the utility provider or merchant or somebody. There is more than 100 different payment kiosk operators, hundreds of networks, which serves more than 200,000 points all over the Russia, with different protocols, with different types of contract and model of integration. We are happy, only two main systems of banking cards, Visa and Master. We have almost issuers in Russia. We have up to 10 different e-money issuers with different protocols, with different models of settlement and collaboration, and other mobile billings, distant bankings, and other players, which provide absolutely uneven landscape of integration. It's quite complicated to collect payment in Russia. And what goes on for customer? What customer does in this landscape? Customer tries to find something simple. Here is one of the event, which was 2 years ago, where customers found that government cannot help in this flooding, collected, crowdfunded more than 4 million rubles in 10 days by the digital money. Why? Why digital money? Why not cards or not banking transfers? Because it is simple. Digital money provided as simple interface as sending email. Like you can attach money from your banking card to email and send it to your Gmail account or Yandex account or somebody. And then receiver will just withdraw this money to banking account or banking card. The second case were crowdfunded protests in Russia, where customers also collected millions of rubles through 2 or 3 days, also through digital monies, because they could just go to any retail branch of any bank or any kiosk, bring cash, type in a phone number of collector, of collecting person who will be crowdfunded, and deliver this money immediately to the receiver. Customer doesn't want to be bothered by complicated payment process. And maybe the last sample of Russian reality is our national opposition anti-corruption project, which also very successful in crowdfunding and also prefers to use simple payment methods. In general, customers made this decision. They already prefer to use something technically simple, without special instrument, without special knowledges, without education which could be required to use this payment instrument. Unfortunately, it doesn't make our government happy, and this year we have new regulation in Russia, according which every peer-to-peer operation between Russian customers must be identified. And we will have much more new improvements in our e-money systems in Russian players to elaborate this requirement. But if it, we'll have a look at the general situation, not only in Russia, but also in other countries, it is not so easy out of Russia. It's a complicated trick to move money from one country to another, from one payment system to another one. And if it has any direct integration, which is developed by the players, or there is special trick between person which can move money between other accounts from one system to another system, it's almost impossible. And no one tries to make it simpler, because there is no interest from the payment system players, there is no interest from the government, from the regulators. Nobody wants to make it kind of open source, to make the joint platform which could provide one common protocol for all players, which could provide one area, one environment to all the payment transactions. Even in Europe, you haven't yet one operational system which could provide such environment. And merchants are obliged to implement many payment protocols to collect money all over the world, especially if you are merchant of global type like Skype or Blizzard. You have to implement dozens of payment protocols, dozens of different settlement scenarios, dozens of special gateways. The same situation is for customer. At the moment, customer needs to open different account for different purposes. One for their transferring money from their banking account to another one, one from for their sharing payments with a friend, or one for their cross-border remittances. It's complicated way to live. And as I understand, no one who could win this war will bring simplicity to the field. Because even our payment system would be the only one in Russia, it wouldn't be simplify the merchant experience. We wouldn't replace all other payment instruments like cards and banking accounts and cash. In fact, we need one platform made not by commercial player. We need a solution made for the industry, but not for the list of the players. And if we cannot, at the moment, go from the regulators, from the top, we need go from the bottom, from the IT, to make this protocol, to make this infrastructure, make this environment, and then using it as a standard de facto, provided to our regulators and our big players as a possibility to unify and simplify the process. We have such experience in the internet. We have such organization like W3C, which successfully provided the standard of the HTTP protocol many years ago. And from this year, there is special committee in the W3C, which is related to the separate payment standard. This payment standard is developed, this payment committee includes players from Russia, from Europe, from USA, like PayPal, like Citibank, MasterCard. And we really hope that this initiative will be successful. And in some years, we will get one protocol as simple as we have now for web pages. Just to imagine, if I'm sending email to anyone, I'm not being worried whether it will come or not, because all the emails are working according one protocol, and all the mail servers will support this protocol. There will be some individual settlement and settings and requirements, like size of one email or possibility to accept this email to certain customer, like we have in finance. For example, we have different requirements for the limitation, personal limits of transaction, and additional information for big transaction or cross-border transaction. But in general, protocol is absolutely common. And the same we can create for the payments. Simple address, which will be interpreted equally by every payment provider. I'm not proposing a bicycle because such implementation is already used in different payment systems. It's just most close to me samples. I'm absolutely sure that every payment system has something like that in the back end. And the only difference is the language. If you see, there are different fields, and sense of these fields is absolutely equal. If you will call it by equal names, we will get interoperability we will. And it could be like payment address for any customer of any bank, which could be operated between systems. And the only question will be whether this system has a contract for fast settlement, or they will settle by something international and more slow and complicated just in transfer. I want to propose all the players of this market to join this committee and bring their ideas to this joint payment protocol.